So here we are back to the chapter. So we are discussing about exercise and health. Now that next is routine and medical checkup. You need to visit your doctor regularly and get your height, weight checked. You must also visit a dentist regularly and get our teeth checked as well. The dentist will help you take care of your teeth. Like this, you can help keep maintaining your health and continue to be healthy. The next we will now discuss is diseases. Now this was all about our health. Now we will come to the part of diseases. What is a disease? It is a state of unhealthy condition of body in which one or more parts are affected and the body does not function properly or normally. Diseases are broadly categorized into two main types, that is non-communicable diseases and communicable diseases. The name itself suggests as the non-communicable means it isn't contagious or it does not spread through contact or something, but communicable is a contagious disease. Now we will study them one by one. First is non-communicable diseases. Diseases which cannot be spread from one person to another person are known as non-communicable. As I said earlier, non-communicable diseases can occur because of several reasons such as lack of healthy food, unhealthy lifestyle, allergies, some birth-related diseases and disorders. Now lack of healthy food means the poor people or the deprived people, or maybe some people who don't get proper nutrition or a balanced diet, they lack healthy food, right? So they are prone to diseases and they suffer from deficiency diseases. Now deficiency diseases are like of minerals. Now these minerals are required by the body in small quantities, but the absence will lead to the deficiency diseases. So let us, in this table, as you can see, there is a mineral and the deficiency disease caused by it. So if your body is not getting proper iron, how much is required, you may suffer from anemia, or a person may suffer from anemia. Next is calcium, which leads to stunted growth, rickets or excessive bleeding. If you get a wound, it doesn't stop and it gets excessively bleeded. So now the next is phosphorus. You may have weakness, soft bones and brittle teeth. Then we have sodium, which leads to muscular cramps, potassium, muscle weakness, paralysis, weak nerve responsiveness, etc. Iodine, we have goiter, mental retardation and stunted growth. Children, goiter is a disease where the neck is swollen and it's like a tumor type, but it is due to the deficiency of the mineral iodine. Deficiency of vitamins. Each vitamin regulates a specific function of the body and it also plays a vital role. But the absence, as I told you earlier, will lead to disease. So let us see the vitamins and the deficiency diseases as is per the table. Vitamin A, the deficiency causes night blindness, that is the inability to see in dim light. The vitamin B, we have beriberin, skin diseases, retarded growth and anemia. Vitamin C causes scurvy, that makes the gums swell up and bleed. You can also term this scurvy as sensitivity that you see in the ads, okay, of toothpaste and all. The next is vitamin D. You will have rickets. People suffer from rickets that affects the children's bones and making them soft and brittle. Vitamin K, excessive bleeding from wounds. Like this, people are prone to get diseases. But also there are some other reasons. This was the first one, due to lack of healthy food. Now we have unhealthy lifestyle. What is unhealthy lifestyle? Many non-communicable diseases like heart diseases, abnormal blood pressure, lung disease, cancer, etc. are caused because of unhealthy habits like smoking, drinking, alcohol, or maybe they don't eat a balanced diet, or also maybe due to environmental pollution. Overeating and frequent eating is due to fatty or oily food. This leads to accumulation of extra fat in the body and it causes overweight conditions. This is known as obesity. And once an obese person is prone to get various heart diseases and diabetes and all like this. As you can see in the pictures, these are the unhealthy habits which leads to diseases. So you must avoid them. Next is allergies. Some people react negative to certain things they eat, breathe or touch. For example, some people sneeze a lot when they are exposed to dust. This is known as allergy. People may be allergic to different conditions of temperature or maybe some kind of food or chemicals or medicines like this. this is called allergic conditions, and they cause sneezing, runny nose, sometimes rashes of the skin, itching, vomiting, etc. But also there are some birth related diseases and disorder. Sometimes certain diseases develop even before the birth of a child. For example, in the mother's womb, many children are born with club of foot or some lips. Like, this is birth related disease, or it is previously from the mother's womb. Now we will see the communicable diseases. These are caused by microbes. What are microbes? These are tiny organisms present everywhere in the air, in water, in soil, in food, and they can only be seen through microscopes. Now, some microbes cause communicable diseases. Some, I mentioned some, not all, because some are useful and some are harmful. The harmful ones are called as germs, and the main germs are bacteria, protozoa, fungi, and viruses. When a large number of people living in an area become ill with the same disease at the same time, is called epidemic or the outbreak of the disease. For example, jaundice, cholera, all these are epidemic diseases which are caused by germs and bacteria, microbes, or you can say. Now let us see how these communicable diseases are spread. There are various factors. First is air. Through air it spreads. Then we have insects. It also spreads through contaminated water and food, and also through, then finally we have direct contact. If we have direct contact with the sick person, we are prone to get ill. Now let us see them one by one. Through air, diseases like common cold, measles, influenza, tuberculosis and diphtheria, they all spread through air. Through water, we have diseases like cholera, typhoid, jaundice and diarrhea. They all spread through contaminated water. So if you drink contaminated water, you are prone to get these diseases. Through food, when the food is left uncovered, or you eat spoiled food, you get food poisoning. This also happens through food. Now through insects, diseases like malaria, plague and dengue are spread by blood sucking insects like mosquitoes. They transfer the virus from affected person's body to other person's body. This happens through insects. Now finally we have through direct contact. So if we come contact with the sick person or the ill person, we are prone to get diseases, as there is direct spreading of viruses inside our body too. Now, how to prevent this communicable diseases? We can take simple steps to prevent such diseases. There are mainly, first one is by maintaining hygiene. It includes a set of practices which you will, if you practice, it will help in keeping good health and preventing diseases. So children, basically all that mama teaches you, wash your hands before eating and after using your washroom. Do not eat uncovered food and road from the roadside vendors. Wash fruits and vegetables before eating. Keep the food covered. Drink boiled or pasteurized milk. Always drink clean water. Use clean clothes. Bath daily. Cover your mouth and nose with a handkerchief while coughing or sneezing. All these are the good habits that mama teaches you that you need to practice. It will help you preventing the diseases. The next is also a method called by vaccination. Vaccines are medicines that can be provide a disease from occurring. Vaccines available for diseases like cholera, typhoid, tetanus, polio and etc. So we must get ourselves vaccinated at the right time, so it will help us prevent the disease. Children, now you see the term called, we are going through a global pandemic called coronavirus, right? So what is this coronavirus? It is an infectious disease caused by a newly discovered virus, right? Yet the vaccination is to discovering, and all that news you see in the TVs and through media, social media and all. So most people infected with this virus will experience moderate respiratory illness and recover without requiring a special treatment. But for older people and small children like you, it may be dangerous. So children, stay home and keep yourself safe, and practice these simple steps to avoid this virus. You have to stay home as advised, wear a face mask if you get out for essential supplies, practice social distancing. If you need medical care, be sure to call first. Like if you feel ill or something, you have fever, tell your mama quickly. Cover your mouth while you're coughing and sneezing, as I told you earlier, and clean frequently your hands and clothes. All and children, so this was our lesson, and hope you all are safe at home. Keep the social distancing and all news update, and have a good family time, and I enjoy at your home. Children, thank you.